Hi, I'm Kirsty Meakin from Nao Nails. In this video, we're going to do some gorgeous matte embellishment nails. So we're going to do a design on all of the five nails, creating a full look. And don't forget, we've got the wave nail with the cutout sections that we're going to make even more dramatic. So what we're going to do first is, I've got a selection of embellishments. Now, it does not matter what colour your embellishments are at all, because they will be coloured. We are going to colour these. What we're going to do now is fill these nails with embellishments, and then we will colour the entire surface. So I'm going to put these embellishments on with acrylic. I'm going to start with a little bit of beaded chain. Which is going to sit close to the cuticle, but not all the way. So I'm just sort of getting a rough measurement of how long this is going to be. Get some old cuticle nippers. Cut that length. Sit that onto that nail. I can see where we're going to go. Okay. And I want a little bit of acrylic there. I've got high speed acrylic liquid, so it's going to set quick, which is what I want. I'm going to put that straight on to that acrylic, sit it in it. So you can see why I did the middle first, because it's stable and it's easier to adhere the rest of the chain if you've got that centre stable first. Now with a 3D brush, and you can use any colour acrylic for this, but I'm going to use exactly the same colour as we've used for the base of the nail, which is warm natural beige. I'm going to get some tiny beads. Pop them equally at the back. The dotting tool. Press into your bead. Then I'm going to use some of the pearls we have. Another either side. Then I'm going to get two small beads, one slightly smaller than the other. We're going to move on to the next one. I'm purely using all this for shapes, and I'm putting them on with acrylic because they'll stay. But make sure you remove any of the excess acrylic. Check your positioning before you leave the embellishment to set.
bead in the middle of those. Dotting tool again, straight in the middle. Don't forget to clean up any excess acrylic. So that's all the embellishments put on. So, using a makeup sponge, we're going to start by sponging some of the colour up. So we've got a pale blue, nice and thin, but with the makeup sponge is going to help you get in all those nooks and crannies. So I'm just going to do just over halfway on the nails. I'm going to reverse some of it round. I'm going to take care when I do round the cuticle. And then you're going to blend so it fades with your second colour. So you can now see why we went halfway, well, just over halfway down, so you could blend that over onto each other using your sponge, just like a stippling sponge. You can use a dry part of the sponge to help you blend, so you get that ombre effect. So now the sponging is all dry, what I'm going to do is seal that in with the matte coat. So this is a UV and LED curable gel top coat, but it's matte. We're going to do two coats of this. So we're going to do one for 30 seconds, come out, and then we're going to do another coat for the full 1 minute. The reason I'm doing that is because it will help to keep the paint on there for longer. Make sure you cap the edge of the nail. Cap the edges of all your embellishments. Still want a nice thin coat, but make sure you cap all the edges. Anything that you don't seal, when you come to wipe off the sticky layer, it will be removed. So make sure that you cover all those nooks and crannies. Get all round those embellishments. Put that in for 30 seconds. With the gel residue wipe off solution, you're going to wipe over to remove the sticky layer. It's also going to help you clean up the nail and the skin as well. So what I'm going to do with this part is now I'm going to add some other details to it. I'm just going to add a little bit of one stroke. So I'm literally just using a one stroke technique. If you want to learn how to do a little bit of one stroke, I've also got other videos on the Neo channel that you can look at. And then what I'm going to do is just enhance these little cutout shapes now with a little bit of white paint, even more. And just a little bit of flange, just creating some little commas. So I'm just going to seal it with the matte top coat again now and cure that for 1 minute. I'm going to put a little bit of cuticle oil on. I just need to be wary that if the cuticle oil goes on top of the nail, it'll take away the matte effect. So what I'll do is I'll oil them, I'll rub it all in, massage it in, and then I'll wipe over with the gel residue wipe off solution just to wipe off any of that excess oil, and it'll still reveal the matte effect of the nails.